So good morning, and welcome to the Center for Spiritual Living here in Boise, Idaho. It is my honor to welcome you this morning and to tell you how delighted we are that you are joining us this morning from beautiful, from sunny Idaho, Boise, Idaho. And this morning, we are so beautifully, did I introduce myself? Did I say I'm Jackie Holland? I'm Reverend Jackie Holland, at the Center for Spiritual Living. You know, we're live, so we can't start over. This is the minute that I wish we were recording. Hey, it's chut. So once again, thank you for joining us. Whenever it is that you're watching this, whether it is this morning live with us or later on in the afternoon or any day this week as you are watching this Sunday service, we are delighted that you are here. And with us this morning, as always, the best music in Boise, Idaho, on Sunday morning is brought to you by this magnificent CSL House Band, which of course is directed and led by our magnificent Rex Miller. Yes, Rex Miller, yes. And our drummer, of course, is Phil Bowden, yes. And this morning, back with us after a long hiatus, we have John Bisline. Woo! And also back with us this morning is our very own homegrown, much loved Jen Pacha. Many of you know, yeah, give Jen a hand. So Jen had a little tussle with the dog that ran too fast and pulled her over or something. She can tell you all about that on her Facebook page. Go look at it. But Jen is with us this morning, and we are so delighted to have her. Jen, of course, like so many of our musicians, are kind of quiet right now, although Rex Miller is performing tomorrow night at what time, Rex? At 6 o'clock, 6 p.m. to 9 p.m. at the
Sandbar,
the Riverside, the Sandbar. So, look, they practice social distancing, bring your mask, and go listen to Rex and Pamela DeMarsh tomorrow night at the Sandbar. Where are you, John? You performing anywhere? No, huh? The living room. John is performing in his living room. So if you want to see John perform, do you ever do a Facebook thing, John, where you perform for people? Oh, come on, John. Okay now. And there's not a mask large enough. So let's just turn within for a moment, as we are so blessed this morning to have Maria Blank back on the sound system with us, making us all sound good. We have Cheryl Houdon on our camera this morning, doing the work, trying to know which place to go to next, and we're always trying to confuse her. Thank you. Take a deep breath with me as we just do a check-in with our body, our mind, and our heart this morning. How is your mind? How is your body, and how is your heart? Our beautiful Donna Sheedy brings forth our spiritual practices this morning. Once again, welcome to the Center for Spiritual Living.
Hello, welcome. It is my honor to introduce Elizabeth Edwards, who will light the world religion's candles from the Christ candle. In religious science, we perform this ceremony to acknowledge that all people and all faiths come from one great universal presence, which we call spirit. In lighting these candles, we honor the one family of humanity made up of over 4,000 religions and spiritual traditions throughout the world. This morning, we celebrate the fathers and father figures through these five spiritual paths. We light the first candle for Buddhism, as it teaches that supporting one's father and mother, cherishing wife and children, a peaceful occupation. This is the greatest blessing. We light the second candle to honor Confucianism. There are five relations of utmost importance under heaven: between prince and minister, between father and his children, between husband and wife, between elder and younger siblings, and between friends. We light the third candle for Sikhism. The father instructs and slights, but again hugs him to his bosom. We light the fourth candle for the Native American religions. Do not despise the breath of your fathers, but draw it close to your body. We light the fifth and final candle, honoring New Thought, which teaches the family is a collection of perfect ideas. Therefore, we honor the strength within our father and father figures. So let us quiet our minds and open our hearts to the spiritual message being sung by Jen Potter.
Lord, make me an instrument of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me show love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope. Where there is darkness, light. Where there is sadness, joy. O divine master, grant that I may not so much seek to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love. For it's in giving that we receive, and it's in pardoning that we are pardoned. And it's in dying that we are born to eternal life. Amen.
All right, so let us pray. As we settle in this beautiful sacred space that has been created by Jen, soak in this beauty, this love of spirit, recognizing the one power, the one mind, the one divine presence of God just all around us and in everything seen and unseen. And I know right where I am that God is, and I know the same divine truth for each person within the sound of my voice right now. So we are each beautiful manifestations of spirit right here on this earth, glowing with this love and perfection of God right here, right now. So I bless all of the hands and hearts that have come together to make this service possible. And I bless each person within the sound of my voice that their hearts and minds are open to receiving the message that is coming through Reverend Jackie right now, for them to receive it in the perfect, right way as they need it right now. And I say a special blessing for our dear, beloved Reverend Jackie Holland. As she comes forth and sets aside her humanness, opens up her heart and her mind, allowing spirit to use her as a vessel to deliver the message, and allowing spirit to speak through her to deliver this message that we all need to hear. So I call this service good and so very good. And we say, Namaste, Om, Shante, Ashe, Aho, Amen, and so it is. And here, follow up with Jen Potter.
Thank you.
sun. The dark is coming and the daylight's almost gone, but a change is gonna come. Something on the horizon, yeah, it's beating like a drum. I feel it coming and I know it won't be long, but a change is gonna come. A change is gonna come. A change is gonna come. It's getting hard to find the strength to carry on, but a change is gonna come. Ooh. Almost won, and a change is gonna come. A change is gonna come. A change is gonna come. We've been fighting and the war is almost won, and a change is gonna come.
A change is gonna come, whether we want it or not, as we were talking about before church this morning. Again, I welcome you to the Center for Spiritual Living. It's so wonderful to have people in the sanctuary. Oh, all doing their physical distancing, all being very wonderful. We so appreciate you so very, very much. So what a week. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, what a week. Well, we celebrated Juneteenth. We celebrated the summer solstice. Today we're celebrating Father's Day. This weekend we celebrated stupidity. We won't go into that. I'm just saying it's been a week. It's been a week for all of us. And as I was thinking about yesterday, I don't know how many, did any of you have this energy yesterday that was a little odd, a little unsettling for you yesterday? Anybody? Well, you know, I was feeling it, and I thought that sun would never go down. OMG, I don't know how you guys are doing it, but for me, my body doesn't want to eat dinner until it's dark. Now, that's pretty hard in Boise, Idaho, since it didn't get dark last night to, what, 11 o'clock at night? And that's because it was the summer solstice. You know, I spend a lot of time, and I've done a lot of studies about the winter solstice. Because the winter solstice is, for me, the important one. The winter solstice is the time when the sun finally, you know, comes out, when it finally starts, the wheel begins to turn around to the summer. But I tell you, this week I did some research on the summer solstice, and of course, I have participated in summer solstice activities in the past without really understanding the deep significance of change. You know, life is on a wheel. We move from one season to the other, constantly changing, moving, moving, moving. And yesterday, we celebrated the summer solstice, which is, of course, known as the first day of summer. And it's the longest day of the year in the Northern Hemisphere. And it's when we can finally, especially here in Boise after our crazy weather over the last few weeks, we can finally take a sigh and say, ah, summer's here. Or in my case, I can say, oh, well, too late to put that garden in now. It marks the day when the sun is at its highest point in the sky for the whole year. And of course, our friends in the Southern Hemisphere are celebrating winter solstice yesterday as well. It's the day that has been celebrated since ancient times. There are structures built all over the world that we know were built so that they could maximize the sun on summer solstice or on winter solstice, like Stonehenge and so forth. And it's one of the earliest astronomical observations in human history. So the summer solstice, if you were feeling a little on edge yesterday or a little bit of energy, a lot of energy in your body, it is because unknowingly you were celebrating the summer solstice. It's a pretty important day, I think. I'd say it's a very important day, but it's more than just scientific observations. It's more than just the astronomical sun going around. It's so much more than that. There are many spiritual meanings to the summer solstice, and I want to talk about some of those today. The spiritual meanings are what keeps things alive from generation to generation to generation. And as I was thinking and studying about the summer solstice, I realized that everything that is happening in our world right now is not a coincidence. And as I go through these 10 or 11 spiritual meanings of the summer solstice, I think you'll agree with me once you know what I'm talking about. First of all, purely, summer solstice is a celebration of the sun, obviously. It's the word solstice means sun standing still. And I know last night as I was thinking, am I ever going to be able to stop pulling weeds and get out of this yard? Because as long as the sun was up yesterday, I felt like I sort of had to do that. The summer solstice is a celebration of the return to light. And it so powerfully reminds us that there is a light within each and every one of us. There is a Maybe that light has been hidden. Maybe that light, you haven't felt it for a long time. But that light represents the full potential of who we are and what we can become. It's the Christ consciousness that we talk about in this faith so much. The unity of the light between human beings is known as the Christ consciousness. It's also called enlightenment, awakening, triumph over darkness, over ignorance, over separation. When we are in the Christ consciousness, we are fully orbed in our human potential, who and what we are. When we reach that zenith of the Christ consciousness, which doesn't happen for all of us very often, but it does happen, we can sense and know that the light that is within us has been ignited. And so we breathe in the light and we breathe out the radiance. We breathe in the light and we breathe out the Christ consciousness. The summer solstice is a gentle and loving reminder that it's about awakening. It's about awakening. It's an important symbol of ascension and the ultimate triumph of light over darkness. And when I think about what is going on in our world today with our Black Lives Matter movement, with everything that has happened in this country in the last few months, the darkness of the pandemic, the darkness of uncertainty and fear, the concerns about not knowing, the idea that finally things are coming into the light to be looked at. The summer solstice is an amazing reminder to us that it is about awakening, searching and reaching for enlightenment, igniting the fire, the light that is within us. And the summer solstice is also a time for reflection. It is a time, yes, it's clearly about nature, of course. Nature lovers, you all know that. But it's also, the summer solstice is an opportunity for us to look at our relationship that we have with ourselves. What is the relationship that you have with yourself? The summer solstice is about inner reflection. Inner reflection. Ask Angels says this: the solstice is a natural way to reconnect with life's divine plan and to feel a deep connection to all of life and the natural world. Reflecting on your journey is a wonderful way to celebrate the solstice. The solstice, which was yesterday, but you can begin your celebrations at any time this week. So it's a time to reflect. It's a time to reflect and to honor and celebrate your unique journey. The sun makes its path. The earth moves and makes its path every year. Your unique journey is worth celebrating. But it's also a time to reflect right now on what is mine to do. What is my journey to look like now? So it's a time to look at the spiritual path that we have walked and to ask ourselves, is it serving us? Or is it time to take the path not taken, a new path? Clearly, the summer solstice is a time to celebrate nature. The summer solstice ushers in a new season that's all about beautiful nature. You know, actually, I think that's more the spring solstice for me, but it really depends on where you live, isn't it? But the summer solstice is about nature, and I am so grateful that we here in Idaho are fairly safe. We're not completely safe, but we're fairly safe, and that we can go and walk by the Boise River, that we can go and take our nature walks, that we can be outside. The summer solstice is about bringing in nature's bounty, and it's an important time for us to stop, look around us, and be grateful for what the earth has given us, for what Mother Earth is offering us. The summer solstice is a time for us to stop and breathe in all that nature and Mother Earth is offering to us in this amazing season of the light. And just as it is a time for reflection, it's also an inner spiritual journey. Yeah, you've got to connect with nature, but it's also about recognizing and connecting to your own spirituality, as I alluded to earlier. It's about your inner spiritual journey. Again, in the book, The Path of the Spiritual Sun, Laura Atwood, who is a real expert in most of this kind of ritual stuff, said this: the progress of the sun throughout the year symbolizes the process of attaining enlightenment, and the summer solstice is the final climax of this journey as the day of the most light of the year. It symbolizes ascension, which we find in so many different religions. It is also, the summer solstice symbolizes the return and the ascension of the great Father Spirit. So it's no mistake that we celebrate Father's Day around the summer solstice. A connection I had never made before. Very interesting to me. It's a time to celebrate the triumph of light over darkness in all of us, in you, in me, and in all of humanity. It's a time of new beginnings, they say. It's a time to reflect, to look at your goals. You know, at the winter solstice time, we set our New Year's goals. That's about the time we begin to start thinking about, what do I want to do next year? What do I want to do next year? The summer solstice gives us a time which is exactly halfway in the middle of the year for us to reflect on those goals that we set in December and early January. It gives us an opportunity to stop and to reflect. Here I am in the middle of the year, and how did I do with my goals? Anybody? Okay, all of you in this room and at home, if you met all of your goals, raise your hand. Okay, so we're going to get a pass this year, aren't we? Who would have thought that a few weeks after we set our goals for ourselves and our world, that this thing called pandemic would hit our world and our country? Who would have thought that 4 months later, this thing called civil rights, equal rights, would raise its head again? I can tell you that in my year-end goals, I did have peace on earth. And so I'm taking the summer solstice time to reflect on which of my goals have come true and which have not. And do I need to look at the goals that I made? Do I need to make that journey within and ask myself, what was important to me then? Is it important to me now? You know, all of these rituals, all of these holidays are just excuses for us to focus on something. That's really all they are. And we use these rituals and these holiday times and these events to bring our awareness back to where it belongs. We're at the middle of the year. How are we doing? It's time to begin again, to recreate our goals, our desires, our vision for the world. The summer solstice is aligned with the element of fire, with passion, with will, and with drive. Fire, passion, will, and drive. Have you been watching the news lately? If we could describe the feeling of humans everywhere on the streets, however they are speaking their truth to power, it is filled with fire, with passion, with will, and with drive. And that's why I say to you, I'm not surprised that all of this is coming up around the summer solstice. And so now is the time to seek right action, to choose the path that you want to walk, to ask yourself, is our walk in alignment with our beliefs? I'm so surprised sometimes by people that I personally know, including members of my family and so forth, that say one thing, but their walk is different. And I am as guilty as any other human being on earth about that myself. Because sometimes we say what we want to be true, but our walk reflects something differently. This is a time where we can stop and ask ourselves, as I look at the grander scope of my life and my spiritual path and the choices that I am making, what is out of alignment right now? And I'm not asking you to people please. It's too easy for us to try to people please. Because my minister says this, and because my best friends are out there doing that, if it's not your truth, it's not your truth. But this is a wonderful time to stop in the brightest time of the year and ask yourself, is my walk of life in alignment with what I believe? And if it isn't, what a wonderful opportunity we have to reconnect. What a marvelous opportunity we have to set a new course. So the summer solstice is a time of new beginnings. It's a time to start something new, just as Mother Earth is starting a new season called the summer. And for me, the summer solstice also represents summer. When I'm saying summer, I am talking about the summer solstice and the season of summer. It is a time for me to do something that is difficult for me to do, which is to slow down. You know, summer almost forces us to do it. Of course, with the advent of air conditioning, The rage of Mother Earth, of course, is a little bit softened, but I want you to think about this. If you did not have air conditioning, how much running around would you be doing in the middle of this summer? You probably wouldn't. So summer, in her purest form, is an opportunity to say to us, slow down. Find patience. Look inside yourself and do something new, but don't get crazy about it, Mother Earth is saying. She's saying, slow down. There's a slow ride to summer. It teaches us patience. There's a rhythm to summer. You know, the fruit stays green until it ripens. I don't care how impatient you are for those peaches on the tree in your backyard to ripen, it isn't going to ripen by your patience any quicker. Nah, it doesn't know. You can't rush it. There's something inside of us that has got the slow, sure rhythm of time, of patience. If we can learn to relax, learn to let go, and the important word here is learn to trust. Trust. Trust that the earth knows what it is doing. Trust that you know what you are doing. Trust that there's a power and a presence that is here, that is supporting us, sustaining us, lifting us, sheltering us. And that takes time and patience and faith to walk through. The seeds of spring were planted. The seeds of a new world have been planted. That which you are watching on the news, that which you are seeing in your own streets in Boise, Idaho, they are the seeds that are being planted for our new world. And just as we take care of the seeds in our gardens, we also take care of the seeds of patience and love and oneness, equality. We take care of those seeds, but our impatience will not make it grow any faster. Only our love will. Only our support, our belief, our vision, and our speaking truth will help those seeds come to full growth, fully formed, fully orbed, fully blossoming. As we've said, it represents fire. The summer solstice represents fire, and if you've ever gone to any of these Wiccan festivals, you know that they light fires, which is kind of weird to me on a hot day while we do it, but it represents fire, which represents the real passion that is within us. The festival of the fire, of course. Fire cleanses. Fire changes. Fire destroys. Again, I say, I think it's no mistake what is happening. And I'm amused because when I went to college a long time ago, of course, there were all of these student uprisings in the spring. Spring and summer. And I used to think it was because, well, that's because we're not going to get out and protest when it's cold. But now I realize that it's probably more the rhythm of the earth that is calling us forth. This is the time. This is the time to celebrate the full force of the sun. It's a good time to remember that we, like the fire, like the sun, contain the power to mature, to sustain, and that we have the responsibility to burn as brightly as we can. That's what summer solstice comes to remind me of. And it represents a peak in the summer, a peak. Most of all, it represents change. It represents change for all of us. It represents prosperity and abundance. When I looked around yesterday, I thought, well, I got an abundance of weeds in my yard. But in addition to that, the sun brought this forth. could not have happened without the Son. So we have to recognize that in life, there's going to be the good that we want, brought to us by the fire, by the Son, by the passion. There's a lot of good the passion brings. There's a lot of good that the fire brings, but there's also some things that we don't want. So it is our job to be spiritually mature and to root that out, just as we do the weeds that are in our garden. The summer comes to remind us that we are the fire of God itself, that our world is abundant. Our ancestors were able to take a break from cultivating their farms and their fields and to reap the rewards of their hard work by celebrating the summer solstice. I think that's probably one of the reasons that we as humans have lost a little bit of the celebration of summer solstice, because we're not reminded. How many of us are out tilling the soil? Well, some of you. Some of you are gardeners. But I'm talking about those farmers, those people, our ancestors, who worked so hard in the spring, and the summer solstice came to remind them, slow down. Take a break. It will be there. Have faith. Have trust. And I think for me, the thing about the summer solstice that I think is really pretty neat is that it's a global movement, that it's a global celebration, that it's a time that people all over the world are celebrating something new coming forth in their world, in their individual lives, in their individual worlds. I love it. It reminds me that I'm part of a global community, that I'm just not up here in Boise, Idaho, but that I'm part of a whole movement of people who are celebrating the return of the light, of the sun, of the passion, of the magnificence of their own light. And as I celebrate that in myself, I'm celebrating it with people all over the world. And I plan to celebrate this every year now, just as I celebrate the winter solstice. I plan to celebrate it to remind myself that the summer solstice is a time to stop and remind me that I am the light of God itself. That as the sun shines the longest day of the year, which was yesterday, it also reminds me that our days now become shorter until we enter into the darkness once again. But that darkness doesn't have to be negative. As the days shorten, we can use that as a reminder to ourselves that time is getting shorter. Time is getting shorter, and we must use all of the light that is available to us. All of the light that is available in our hearts, in our minds, and in each other. It's a global movement to remind us of that. So we can celebrate it, and I invite all of us to celebrate it by going outside, by breathing in the sun, by doing your own fire ceremony and lighting a candle, setting new goals for the next 6 months, and ask yourself, how has my world changed as a result of what I've been through in the last 5 months? How can I change what I thought my world was going to be? At the same time, I can change the world of so many other people. It's a high point in life, and I invite all of us right this moment to reflect. If you'll turn within with me for just a moment as Rex is coming back up. It's a time of reflection, so I want to give us a moment just to reflect inwardly. I want you to take a moment and take a deep breath in your solar plexus, that spot above your belly and belly, your belly button and below your ribs. Take a deep breath in of illumination, of light. Breathe it in deeply into that spot. And as you breathe out radiance. Radiance. Breathe in illumination. Breathe out radiance. And as you are breathing out, sending into our world your light. Your light. Breathing in the radiance, bringing in the illumination and the light of God itself, and breathing out radiance. Do this consciously now. And in your out breath, in your mind's eye and in your heart, make a declaration for our world right now. I invite you to vision one or two things that you believe are important to see manifest on planet Earth right now. The longest day of the year comes to remind us of the light of God itself. And now shift your attention to yourself, to your life journey. You see, in order to bring to planet Earth that which you just visioned, you must become it yourself. What in your life journey has prepared you to be the light bearer that you are? And what is yours to do now to become that which you have declared for all of us? Thank you, living, loving life almighty. How blessed we are to celebrate the light within each and every one of us, because we know that it is the light of God making itself known through us. The light in me beholds the light in you. The love in me beholds the love in you and all people. Because we are all one in this magnificent power and presence that is love itself. Father, Mother, God, Infinite Spirit, living life, that which woke us up, that which woke us up this morning with a song in our heart. We say thank you, God. We say thank you, Spirit, for our conscious knowing of our connection with this great Creator. And as it creates, we too can create our world in a new and better way. This morning, we express infinite gratitude, appreciation for that figure in our life called Father. Whether he is your biological father or a male figure or your mother who served the father role, we simply celebrate this idea of Father. that quality of God that represents strength and power, intelligence and love. Whether your father was present in your life or your father left, whether your father was a loving, cuddly dad or a distant, emotionally separate individual, whether you knew your dad or you did not, the reality is that we owe a debt of gratitude to the male who gave us life. We say thank you, God, for our understanding that whoever he was, whatever he did, he was acting in the only way that he could, given his understanding of who he was at the time. And for those lucky enough to have the Father's Knows Best experience, I say thank you, God, for that. As we celebrate our fathers today with love and appreciation. And so I ask you to bring to your mind's eye right now that male individual who served, or that individual that served as father to you. Bring him into your mind's eye. And if there is anything to forgive, please forgive. And if there is anything to be grateful for, to express your gratitude right now in your heart and in your mind, express it however you wish. Thank you, Infinite Spirit. Thank you, God, for our fathers and our father figures. And I say thank you, God, for the absolute perfect surgery for our beloved Barbara this week. She is having heart surgery. And I say thank you, God, for all of the prayers that have been received here at the Center for Spiritual Living. We know it is a divine idea in the mind of God long before it was even spoken. And for this, we are deeply grateful as we allow the prototype of God to be made manifest on earth right now. Take a deep breath with me of illumination and breathe out radiance, fire and passion. And so it is. Amen. Amen. Happy Father's Day to all of you out there. I know it's going to be a day of barbecues and a lot of fun, and we wish you much joy. And for those of you who are missing your dads, our hearts are with you right now. Let's take a deep breath together, and where you are at home, if somebody's in the room with you, turn to them and do the namaste as you will in this. And if you're alone, look right here in the camera, namaste. You are loved. You are loved. And so get out in nature. Celebrate the summer solstice for a couple of more days. It'll be fun for you. I just want to remind all of you that are with us online that about 5 minutes after service, we're changing up things up just a little bit. We're not going to wait till 11:45 to have our Zoom meeting, our Zoom hospitality together. We're going to give ourselves about 3 to 5 minutes after service so we can handle a little bit of business, and then we're going to start our Zoom right away to see if some of you would perhaps like to join us. And I know that it is on your e-blast and other places that you can just click on Zoom and be right in the room with us and get to see everybody's face and talk about the service or ask each other questions, whatever. Just a little time for us to get together and see each other. And I want to also say to you during this announcement time and as you're getting ready with your gift and your offering, that truly, what a wonderful opportunity we have to pray with you. When you're in the church, as so many of you are, you can fill out this blue request form that's found in the front of the chairs. But if you are at home and you have a prayer request, our practitioners are really anxious and eager, I should say eager, not anxious, to pray with you. And so you can call the prayer line at 208-375-0791. And leave your prayer request, and Loretta Knowles checks that several times a day, and we'll get back to you, and we'll be praying with you. Or you can go to CSLBoise.org, and fill out an online prayer request. It just simply says, how may we pray with you? Let us know. Or you can call the church, but really those practitioners are standing by. So if you are in need of prayer for any reason, the practitioners and I had a meeting yesterday, a Zoom meeting yesterday, and we said, wow, now as people are isolating, they're not requesting prayer so much. So our practitioners are ready to pray with you. And also, if you are visiting with the church for the first time, those of you who are in the sanctuary, or you have never completed one of these welcome connection cards, again, they're in the seat. And for those of you who are watching us on Facebook Live, if you want to be put on our mailing list and you are not on our mailing list, once again, go to cslboise.org and you will be put on our mailing list to receive our e-blast, which is which comes out every single Thursday night. It lets you know everything that's going on in the church, and it has taken the place of newsletters and any kind of pieces of paper. And if you want to know more about us, just go to cslboise.org and you can find out all about our practitioners. But for those of you who are in the church today, you can pick up this brochure. And so so there are some very exciting plans that are happening here at the CSL Boise. We are looking at how to recreate our church, and we would love to hear from you. While the church is opening up, we recognize that life has changed for so many people, and we are inviting you to participate in the recreation of this Center for Spiritual Living. When we can come back, and for those of you who are still here, we're looking at many different things in which you can participate. Some classes, some workshops, some fun activities. So stay tuned for the announcement of all of those things. And I just want to announce really something very, very exciting. And that is that members of our church, Seth Randall and Shadi Ishmael, how do I say it? Ishmael Shadi. You all know who Shadi is. He spoke at the church. He is an amazing man, and his story of escaping from where he lived to come here to this country as a gay man, everything that he went through. And Seth Randall, also a gay man, is going to be on unityonlineradio.org. unityonlineradio.org Tuesday at 1 o'clock. I'm going to put that on our CSL Facebook page, and you'll be able to listen in to hear Seth and Shadi talk about their journeys during this Pride Month. It's a very exciting time. unityonlineradio.org. So this is our conscious giving time. And I am reminded so clearly during this pandemic time, and you're not here in the church, how difficult No, let me back up and say how easy it is to forget why we give. It's really easy to forget that we truly give not because this church needs your money to keep the air conditioning running and the building and all of that. That's true, of course. Church continues. The expenses of the church continues. But the reason that we want to remember about giving is that it is a spiritual principle. It is a spiritual principle that can change your life. So it is conscious giving that we teach here. We teach that we want to keep the law of circulation going in our lives. We want to participate in the circulation of life. And as we give, so shall we receive. And so we give to our spiritual home and we give to other places so that we can stay in the circulation of life. The number one reason that every Sunday I get up here and I hold these checks up and I say thank you, thank you, thank you to the individuals who have sent checks to the church, people who give through bill pay, people who give through our e-giving. There's all kinds of ways. Go once again, go to our website and you can give that way, or you can give through our many, many different ways of giving. But the reason that we do it is because we believe in the spiritual principle of giving, conscious giving, as strongly as we believe in the spiritual principle and the healing power of prayer. So I'm saying to you, especially during the difficult times, it is a time to remember to stay in the circulation of life. And yes, we're asking you to help support your spiritual home, but circulate, circulate, circulate. It is a principle that will change your life, and I will tell you about it, but it's time for us to close up. So let's just take a moment and take the gifts and offering in our hands as Joe Hughes gets our basket, please. There will not be a basket in the church, but JJ will be holding the basket as you go out. So I just want you to recognize that these are all individuals who have said, yes, I want to participate in the circulation of life itself. And so we just want to say thank you. Thank you for your giving, but most of all, thank you for your consciousness of spiritual maturity and really exercising that muscle of staying in the law of circulation. So let's just take our gift, our offering in our hands, right where you are at home, here in the sanctuary, as we say thank you, God. Thank you for the abundance. Thank you for the prosperity. Thank you for the love. As I say, and you silently say to yourself, divine love as me, blesses and multiplies all that I am, all that I have, and all that I circulate. And so it is. Amen, amen, amen. Ladies and gentlemen, the magnificent Jen Pacha.
It's been a long, dark night, and I've been waiting for the morning. It's been a long, hard fight, but I see a brand new day dawning. I've been looking for the sunshine, 'cause I ain't seen it in so long. But everything's gonna work out just fine. Everything's gonna be alright. It's been all wrong, 'cause I can see the light of a clear blue morning. I can see the light of a brand new day, yeah. I can see the light of a clear blue morning, and everything's gonna be alright. It's gonna be okay. It's been a long time since I've known the taste of freedom, but those clinging vines that had me bound, well, I don't need them, 'cause I am strong and I can prove it. I got my dreams to see me through, and I can see the light of a clear blue morning. I can see the light of a brand new day. Yeah, I can see the light of a clear blue morning. Everything's gonna be alright, it's gonna be okay. I can't see the light of a clear blue morning. I can't see the light of a brand new day. Yes, I can't see the light of a clear blue morning. And everything's gonna be alright. Everything's gonna be alright. Everything's gonna be alright. It's gonna be okay. 'Cause I can't see the light of a clear blue morning. It's gonna be alright, it's gonna be alright. I can see the light, I can see the light. It's gonna be alright, it's gonna be alright.
Yay! Woohoo! So let's end this summer solstice and Father's Day celebration by standing and receiving your prayer and your blessing, and for all those in the room and all those at home, blessing to all this week with love and peace, joy and happiness and positive abundance. May you spread the light and you be the light to all that you encounter. And so it is. So have a great week. Thanks for being here.